Hey guys, welcome back. Right, season three, we're getting underway. So very excited for that. First things first, let's reveal the car. Now. So this was voted for over the weekend by you guys, and this is what we went with. Very exciting. No, not really. But anyway, so this was the chosen design. So this is what we're running.
Our margins are looking good right now. I think we've got room for some more.
And on top of that, we have a lot of R&D development or department upgrades. Personnel is going up to a level 3 straight off the bat. And I've gone resource point generation for all departments, because we're not going to be doing practices anymore, so we want to create as many resources as possible. And we've got 12 million in the bank, so I think probably the department that we could do with the most increase is that one. The durability. Not that our car's struggling with durability, I just want to make sure our teammate is good. Other things that we've done, we have kept Lando, did a great job actually. When I simmed through the remaining races, he won I think 3 of 4 with me coming second in the rest. And I've also pushed difficulty up to 100. From 85. I've held off on the pit limiter thing just for the minute. That may be something that I'll bring in soon. But in the meantime, it's our qualifying times are going to be difficult, but I think race wise I ran one race with it in the US, which is not always the fastest track for me, and we did fine. But you see, we've taken a bit of a drop on R&D points, not masses, but enough. The other thing I haven't checked out is where everyone went, because I didn't move and we had Vettel retire. So where are we at? Valtteri and Lewis did in Mercedes. Leclerc is now joined by Matsushita. Jeez, they brought Matsushita in? Okay, wasn't expecting that one. Ricardo, Ocon, Sainz, Raikkonen, Perez, Stroll, Verstappen, Albon, Gasly, Kvyat. So I don't actually think there's been any changes from last season, apart from Matsushita's now taking in Vettel's role, which surprises me. I was actually expecting quite a few to drop him. In terms of the results of the R&D situation, a few teams went up, a lot of them went down, which is not surprising. But we took a really nice big jump, so we're clearly ahead at the moment. And the next thing we're going to concentrate on, now that we are spec free, we're going to probably share the wealth. In terms of speed, we're good. So I want to, this season, knock a couple more durability upgrades out. And then we'll go from there. But we'll do that after the race. Anyway, let's go on with qualifying. as I say, I haven't been particularly strong in my short lap pace with qualifying, and I'm not great in Australia, but we've never won here in my career, and I really like to win, so let's see how we do. I think now that we've got rid of Pratt's, gone are the days. Gone are the days of the single practice. TV's up a bit loud, so I'm gonna turn that down a bit. Oh yeah, we also switched to a Renault engine because apparently Renault had the most powerful engine. We've run Mercedes first two seasons. I thought it was time for a change up. Not the cleanest first lap. It's the first time out in this new car, so. Well, this Renault sounds weird. Being so used to the Mercedes. Poor first lap. Where's it going to put us?
2 laps of fuel left.
Why do you put so much fuel in it? Normally he's crying at me, he's running out of fuel. You never quite get that chicane accurate. Half a second up on our previous lap, but still some time off. Ugh.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 20.1.
We need to find about a second. Jesus. Gone are the days of us strolling this by a couple of seconds. Early thoughts on the car feels pretty nice actually. Thank you. push too much at the moment. I'm trying to find some time and I can't. Seem to figure out where it's going to come from. That was going to end badly. Oh, come on. This chicane. Just need to start learning how to get it right. Consistently not good. I just can't seem to find the time anywhere. Out on track.
Fuel remaining.
I think that's just going to be where we're at. I'm not great in Australia, and it's kind of showing right now. We make the top 16, we're lucky. No, we're 17th. Brilliant. I'm gonna go Albon because I get the same points.
You left some body work out there on the track. Are you struggling for grip?
I didn't hit anything, did I?
Great. Well, that's everything.
Okay. Is it worth, I know it's first race of the season, but take an engine penalty, bank that fourth one early.
Tough luck there. It's not quite where we'd want to be on the grid, but chin up, it's not the end of the world.
Yeah. I'm gonna do it. So we'll take that new engine, and that will do us easily through the end of the year, like last season. But
before we begin,
with the Brucey bonus that
first race we weren't having, and unfortunately,
oh balls! I didn't check this tractor. Oh, it's all gone badly at the start. we've not made any play. Oh shit. Fit out very wide there, but of the AI to make up a couple of places. Get some feel underneath us to start. Elf is coming back at us. Get locked back on the back of Matt's cheetah. Bit there.
DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Forward progress has slowed down a bit. It's just not fast coming out of corners.
Okay, battery's looking good. You can use overtake to get past.
This tends to be my Australia issue anyway.
Time to utilize some of this energy. Confirmed, moving the angle of the front wing to a plus one setup.
That's not what I said. and Chloe. Bit of fighting going up my head. From not being close to running in the back of someone in one corner. I'm going to try and go late. What I was thinking, Jeff. A bit closer to actually to not close enough, I don't think. Pulling away from me on the straight. And I'm getting very hot doing it. There soon. Right, a grip through the last corner because I'm getting washed. No, fuck that up.
Some information on Ocon. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car.
Serious. save DRS this time round. Ocon was ahead of us, and he's what's causing this battle. What's causing this backlog of cars?
If you continue to cut corners, the stewards will give you a penalty.
Oh! Oh!
Are you alright? Engine off, engine off.
Literally had nowhere to go. Oh, it's gone badly. Oh, it's gone horribly badly. Massively here.
We advise moving to mix two, fuel to mix two.
Try and take at least one here. Giving him space. So the first of the pit stops. These guys risking a two stop.
Okay, you're in the top ten.
Norris is only 8, so he's not having a superb race, but the time behind Ocon has cost us dearly.
Overtake and burn some of this energy.
Car's just washing out so badly behind others. Some more guys going on hards this time around. I didn't hit Albon. He played and I kind of blocked his path, but I didn't hit him. Norris via about 7 seconds up the road. Lando's not exactly having a stellar weekend like us.
Okay, gap ahead is 7.4 seconds.
That chicane now. I'm guessing everyone coming in the pits now is going hard, and it weirdly put me in the lead. So I've gone from last to first. It should give me a big tyre advantage over everyone around me. Later in the race. Okay about our strategy right now for us to keep gaining some more points.
Go, go, go.
Why was my nose changed? Did I have nose damage?
Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres.
That's a pain in the butt.
Look after these tyres now.
There's nothing I can do with Harris. Turned into me. Coming out of pits. we've got some drive coming off the corners.
Position, that's us down a place. We're trailing our team.
Oh, seriously?
13.8 seconds.
Seconds to Albon to get back in the points. The wind's definitely gone away from us now, but we've got 15 laps. See what we can make up.
Spare energy, use your overtake button. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. Nice move. Good job.
Right, we're back in points. Ricardo's in hit, so that gives us ninth. Cut off, would you? Lando's got a problem. I can see it flashing up on the screen, on the map.
Lando is out of the race. Our gap to the car in front is 3.3 seconds.
Slowly but surely.
Manage your tires.
Getting closer.
The gap to the car ahead is 1.6 seconds.
right on top of them now. Look for the first sector.
If you think you can get past, make use of the overtake button and see what you can do.
Don't worry, I'm giving it all the juice. Early on the brakes there. And I was late there. Fifth's not out of the question. I see Gasly just up ahead. Sweeping around the outside there.
Some information on De Vries, they are out of the race. Virtual safety car, reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Okay, clear. The car in front is 2.6 seconds.
Probably put it on the full safety car there.
Caution, caution, yellow flags ahead. No overtaking through the caution zone. Be careful until you see the greens.
So 2.4 to Gasly.
This pace is
six laps to go.
Away. Your tires need to go the distance.
Thank you. Come on, son. It's dripping away a little bit. There they are. Normally a bit better through the middle section anyway. Pretty much.
You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap.
Match Gasly that time.
Is 2.0 seconds.
I think Gasly's actually also catching the stat.
We have 5 laps of fuel remaining.
And then fourth might be on. Just out of DRS zone for now.
Battery charge is high. Let's use that overtake button more.
I was inside 1 second over that detection point. I know I was because I checked. Bastard. I want to get Gasly before he gets in range on Verstappen. Outside DRS, I lost way too much time into that chicane.
We pretty much burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn.
Not giving me DRS again.
car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. We've only got 2 laps of fuel left. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. What happened? Let me know you're okay.
Put a toe on the grass. I think Verstappen is too far away, but
there's only one lap of fuel.
Verstappen's too far away, but we can get Gasly. Come on, give her everything she's got. I think it might be a dive bomb into the large chicane, to be perfectly honest. Second. I'll just wrap that up because I was way out of line. Yeah. last to sig. Take that.
Alright, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
As I say, not one of my favourite tracks.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race week.
One here.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's
table. Pace-wise, I was a million miles away.
The driver's championship after an excellent result. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to Thomas. He did a great job.
I tell you what, let's go for two.
Fans really seem to enjoy that. Made it look easy. Did you struggle to get through all that traffic today? Appreciate your time.
Could have been a lot worse. But we haven't started the season well before. We've come out okay. So I tell you what, let's go straight to Bahrain. Let's just carry on. I get all the level 2s done, plus the ICE, because the ICE fails a lot. Then we'll get back onto regular development. All our spec upgrades are coming. Right, Bahrain, I can do. Okay. Again, single lap pace though worries me. We're gonna switch the engines back, gotta remember to do that. And the engines will basically run. Actually, I won't. Number four will just do the start of the year. And then basically every time we get a gearbox upgrade, or gearbox change, we'll change the ICE as well. Banker time's going.
Thank you.
relatively clean lap so far, if not spectacular, but clean.
Of fuel remaining.
Tap that middle section a lot harder. It was working out for me, but then I messed it up into the hairpin round too deep. Earlier turn in, didn't work.
P17.
All right, this is a worry again. Thank you. That was pretty bad. It's a bit better. 14. Trying to get every inch of extra room. Nope. Happening for me, is it? One more go. That's as fast as I can do it. Oh, I snuck in. 125.4. So I'm 1.2 seconds off my teammate, and I literally can't figure out where I can make that up. And it's not like race pace is an issue, it's just qualifying. I'm miles away.
Track is quiet right now. Let's get out on track while it's clear.
Well, that's not clear, is it? Yeah, based on Q3, I'm not Q1, I'm not planning on getting in Q3. It's just trying to get as high grid spot as possible. Trying to be as perfect as possible. And that's the best I can do with, because I can't use multiple tires.
Our best lap so far is a 125.5.
I think that's going to have to do. Wait, where am I losing sector time in comparison to my teammate? Faster in sector one. Faster overall in the last sector. Middle sector, I'm losing 7/10, and he was on mediums. I know it's the wiggly stuff, which especially why Australia was such a bum result. This one, let's try some fun.
Off the back of a fantastic.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
So let's start first strategy and let's go. Oh, I can't. That far back and then that on the socks. Could do it. Right, so no penis. I don't want this final stint. It's going to look something like that. Better start this week. Just trying to avoid contact. That's not good contact. Oh, come on. Don't give me some room, actually, to... No. I fucked it up again. That worked nice. Why am I softs? Just realized that. I wanted the fucking hards. Two guys are in the pit. Hamilton and Ricciardo both obviously have wing damage. And they're way out in front. Thank you.
devices being enabled this lap, we can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
So, bringing this gap down a bit.
Okay, we've got plenty of energy. Use the overtake button and have a go.
What straights to use it on. Miss that apex.
Use your overtake button more, it's time to utilize some of this energy.
I am, Jeff.
Fuel to mix two.
I need a lap to try and get back underneath. Back towards the back of Perez. Scampering off into the distance.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy that.
I don't want to pit on that 9.
The gap to teammate ahead is 10.4 seconds. You're losing a small amount of time to the car behind. Keep pushing.
Gasly's coming back at me. Missing gear changes. go, keep it straight. I think I'm going to make some positions up with the one star. Whether I can hold those positions is another story, but... What I can't afford to do is let someone like Gasly get past. It will look there.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the hards.
Get inside the DRS then. No. Yes. Well, everyone goes in the pits now anyway. Brilliant. I know I'm going to lose some spots backwards, but hopefully as well some cars will get caught up in the pack.
Our gap to the car in front is 8.2 seconds.
Bit of a clean road for the moment, but they will catch up with William Singh. Second race in a row, I'm gonna hold the lead for a bit.
Box, box, we're coming in this lap.
No, we're not. So, Lando and Bottas have both gone softs, and they've come out behind a load of medium guys, so that's just gonna take the sting off what they're planning on doing.
concerns at the moment. Just focus on the driving.
Lovely. Be it an odd honour.
To the car behind is 2.8 seconds.
Bit of a Barney, so we've been able to skip away for a minute. I think one of them's hit the other. I think Ocon's out. Yeah, Ocon's out.
Flag. Some information on Ocon. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car.
Oh,
check your MFD for a new strategy option.
For us.
Okay, the safety car is out. The safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time. Make sure to keep it positive. Understood, copy that.
I totally balls it up because I was fiddling with the buttons so much, but it's going to work perfect for us because we've one stop onto hards.
Complete, go now.
Where are we at the moment? We're behind Leclerc, so we're...
We'll be doing one more stop today. One stop left in our strategy.
Yeah. Perez and Gasly have got. I was just about saving some fuel. Really could have done with coming out ahead of Gasly and Perez. I wanted to make sure I got the right tyres. in this lap.
Safety car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember, there is no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Okay, clear.
Shit. Lando left it really late. Back out. I almost got the rum. No! Your neutral issue. That was the important move. Maybe even the clear would be helpful right now.
Let's use overtake and burn some of this energy.
Let's get away from it now. Cutback lane.
Okay, the car ahead is pulling away from you at the rate of around 2 seconds a lap.
Let's just settle down and race now. I know that Alpha Tower is going to be all over my tail for a few more laps, yeah.
Be careful with the front wing. You've taken some minor damage. A new strategy is available on the MFD.
Nah. It's not going to work.
Check your...
Wasn't having that move by him.
The gap to the car ahead is 5.1 seconds.
Even though it did take a little bit of my end plate off, just didn't survive. was in a bit of a queue up behind me.
DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. Strategy is available on the MFD. Okay, copy that. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Got that confirmed.
Question is, when the Valtteri
0.9 seconds.
When the Valtteri and Lando panel coming in. That lap 8 first time round, so I would suspect it soon.
Is 8.0 seconds.
Getting out of it, Pierre. Yeah, so Lando is in.
We're approaching the
return us the lead. No. Charles still about.
Virtual safety car deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed. Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Virtual virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green.
In this lab,
push now.
Can I go an outside shot of winning this? Worst comes to worst. Release Lando. Lando looks like he's in another fucking car to me. Like, that was unreal amounts of extra grip. Seconds up the road, he only just overtook me. Save some stuff because I know these two are going to be on me rather quickly. Don't want a repeat of what Lando just did. He's now 6 seconds up the road. First of all, Sainz ran off the track trying to get round us and lost two spots. And then Bottas physically tried removing us from the track and couldn't. Sometimes flip the switch and it doesn't quite register what I want it to do. However, I am just squeezing these guys out of position there. I knew you were going to try that late dive bomb on me. giving Lando the nice first win of the year for the team. Show between them, which I'm fine with. Sainz now moves in third. It's four of us battling out over the two final steps, with me the cork.
There's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Sainz had learnt his lesson as he go and look outside me. I don't need to defend this harder on this straight, what I'm learning. Back straight, yes, and for some reason the other DRS zone straight, that little middle one, which isn't much of an overtaking point normally, but Lando's already halfway down. Yeah, an awfully good run out of that. Ooh, that was a punt. So, this is going to go badly. It went badly for Leclerc. I think we've got to keep within touch and everything. Without hitting him. So we've squeezed down the inside, and Sainz and Bottas have both hit the pits. They obviously picked up too much wing damage in their crazy moves. So I've just got to deal with Leclerc now. Oh, and Gasly and Perez again.
3 laps of fuel remaining.
Last rain. I think we can pretty much sit in Rich Mix now.
Be aware, we expect the grip levels to start falling away soon.
And those 28 seconds up the road, so much we've been fighting between us.
This is your final lap of the race.
Well, that was mean. Why is it doing that?
Okay, we've lost a position. That's us down a place. Engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty.
Got some fresh tires. Much more of a challenge. Charles. It's quite a long run, so we're going to have to watch up rear. Oh.
OK, Okay, good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
Again.
A fantastic team effort then to secure victory here in the desert. And talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.
So Lando gets the first win of the season for the team.
And now let's take a look at the driver standings. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the
team. Oh, we were miles away from this fastest time.
Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick?
I have to give it to Thomas. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times. So I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
Let's move on to the constructors. Our championship leaders retain their position, but their lead is shrinking. Meanwhile, good work from the owner driver.
I doubt Matt Sheeter's going to keep his ride very much longer with drives like that.
Performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. You and your teammate took the top two positions today. Have you got the best car out there? You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? You must be happy with the result today. Your teammate took the number one spot. Does that make you happy or jealous? Appreciate your time.
Alright guys, I think we're going to leave it there. Good session. But
I mean, think of this one.
Yeah, I think it's time to call it a day for now. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I hope we have some better luck in the next couple of races, but in the meantime, make sure to give us a like or a follow or a subscribe, whatever you can do, and we'll catch you next time. Bye now.